insignificant nothing. The Musters wasted their time on you. Time better spent on other students. You are well named, for you truly are this Academy's Bane.
No!
Bane screamed, thrusting his good hand out, palm forward, even as Foharg leapt in to finish him off. Dark side energy erupted from his open palm to catch his opponent in midair, hurling him back to the edge of the crowd where he landed at Kasim's feet. The master watched with an intrigued but wary expression. Bane slowly clenched his fist and rose to his feet. On the ground before him, Foharg was writhing in agony, clutching at his throat and gasping for breath. Unlike the McCurth, Bane had nothing to say to his helpless opponent. He squeezed his fist harder, feeling the force rushing through him like a divine wind as he crushed the life out of his foe. Foharg's heels pounded out a staccato rhythm on the temple stone roof as his body convulsed. He began to gurgle and pink froth welled up from between his lips. "Enough, Bane," Kasim said in a cold, even voice. Though he stood only centimeters away from the death throes of his student, his eyes were fixed on the one still standing. A final surge of power roared up in the core of Bane's being and exploded out into the world. In response, Foharg's body went stiff and his eyes rolled back in his head. Bane released his hold on the Force and his fallen enemy, and the McCurth's body went limp as the last vestiges of life ebbed away. "Now it's enough," Bane said, turning his back on the corpse and walking toward the stairs that led back inside the temple. The circle of students quickly opened a path for him to pass. He didn't need to look back to know that Kasim was watching him with great interest.